Now we continue with the propagation of sound in a medium. How does the sound travel? How does the sound travel? Travels in the form of waves, in the form of different types of waves. The waves are called as longitudinal waves and the transverse waves. Now how do they propagate? How do they move? Let us try to study. First of all, let me tell you about the air medium. So for example, if I take this as the particles in the air, they are at an equal mean position. Mean position kabhi bolte hai, when they are not moving or stationary at one position. So these are all the layers which are stationary at an equal distance. Getting it? So these are called as at the mean position. Now suppose if I keep a speaker or a some sound object, what happens is as the drum of this propagates the sound, as it propagates the sound, as the sound is created, the vibration travels and it pushes the first layer. It pushes the first layer towards the second layer. So there is a collision between the two layers. So what happens is here the space has become empty. Space has become empty. But now, so here the density becomes less. Here the density has become less and here the density has become more. So what will happen is, again, since the density has become less, this particle which had collided with the second particle will return back to its original position. But by that time, the second particle which was given a push by the first particle will move in a forward direction and will collide with this one. So yahan par particle nahi hai. To ab kya ho gaya? Yahan par density kam ho gaya. Density has become less and here the density has become more. Wapas se, since the density is less, this particle will again come back to its original position, but this will proceed further and collide with the next particle. Again, the density here has become more and density here has become less. So this way, the process goes on continuously, but actually the particle is not moving and carrying the sound till the end. It is only transferring the energy to the next particle and the next particle to its next particle. So this is how they travel from one particle to the other particle. The energy is transferred from one particle to another particle, and when they travel faster, this is only when one vibration is set up. When so many vibrations are set up, what will happen is you will find a layer which is far away, less denser, and a closely packed layer, and then again you can see a dense layer, a less dense layer and a higher density layer. Again further you can see loose material, again a compact material. So such compact material, well, the particles have come together, we call them as compressions, and where the particles are far away from each other, we call them rarefactions. Getting it? So this is about the longitudinal waves. So longitudinal waves travel in the form of compactions and rarefactions. Understood the concept? How the particles are moving? The particles themselves are not carrying the vibration, carrying the sound from one point to the other point. They are just transferring the energy from one to the next, and next will transfer to the next, and next will transfer to the next. This is how they come closer and spread out. Closer and they spread out. When they come closer, the density increases, and when they are spread out, the density decreases. So just to remember about the density and also the pressure. So yahan par density bhi increase ho raha hai aur pressure bhi increase ho raha hai. So this is high pressure zone, this is called as high pressure zone, and this is called as a low pressure zone, where the density is higher and here also the density is lower. Getting it? So this is how the compactions and rarefactions are created. And such type of waves which travel in the form of compactions and rarefactions in a straight line direction are called as longitudinal waves. So I'll be defining it. This was just for your explanation purpose. So when we are speaking about longitudinal waves, we put up different points what the longitudinal waves are made up of. That is one complete to and fro, jaake wapas aana, to and fro motion of the strip bolo ya wave bolo from
one compression and one rarefaction together makes one wave. Getting it? This is just about the wave, how the wave is composed of. When one to and fro motion, when one complete to and fro motion of the strip, to and fro motion of the strip takes place, one compression and one rarefaction are formed together. So this together are called as one wave. How do we define the longitudinal wave? How do we define the longitudinal waves? So the waves in which the particles of the medium, particles are vibrating, they vibrate about their mean position. पार्टिकल्स उधर का उधर ही है, मीन पोजीशन के उधर ही है, खाली आगे पीछे होके कोलाइड होके नेक्स्ट को एनर्जी ट्रांसफर कर रहा है, बट दे आर स्टिल एट द मीन पोजीशन. बट इन द, ये इंपॉर्टेंट है, द डायरेक्शन इज टू बी मेंशन, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ साउंड इज कॉल्ड longitudinal waves. Getting it? The wave in which the particles of the medium vibrate about their mean position. They are vibrating about their mean position. यही एक दूसरे के साथ vibrate कर रही है. But in which direction? In the same direction in which the propagation of sound, in which the sound is traveling. मतलब you can call it as either parallel or anti-parallel. पता है ये क्या होता है? Parallel, it is not there in textbook. Parallel and anti-parallel. मतलब द साउंड इज ट्रेवलिंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन, दोनों भी इसको पैरेलल बोलते हैं, और एंटी पैरेलल मतलब वन मूविंग दिस वे एंड अदर मूविंग दिस वे, दोनों पैरेलल है बट द डायरेक्शंस आर ऑपोजिट, दे आर कॉल्ड एंटी पैरेलल. सो व्हेन द वेव्स आर मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन और इन दिस मैनर, दैट इज द वेव इन विच द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द मीडियम वाइब्रेट अबाउट देयर मीन पोजिशन उधर का उधर, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ द साउंड, इन द सेम डायरेक्शन वेयर द साउंड इज सपोज टू ट्रेवल, देन सच वेव्स आर कॉल्ड एज लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स. समझ में आ रहा है? ओके, वी प्रोसीड. लेट मी क्लियर दिस. पैरेलल एंटी पैरेलल खाली दिमाग में रखना. ओके, हियर ये जो लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स होते हैं, दे आर मोस्टली फॉर द एयर. साउंड ट्रेवल्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल waves. Okay, but actually if you see the longitudinal waves jo hota hai na, they can be produced, sab mein produce hota hai, but uska frequency aur uska intensity alag alag rahega. They can be produced in solids, liquids and also gases. So they can be produced in all the three मीडियम. यू गेटिंग इट? और जस्ट नाउ आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द डेंसिटी पार्ट. जैसे हम लोग ने बोला था कि व्हेन द लेयर्स आर क्लोज टुगेदर दे आर कॉल्ड कॉम्पैक्शंस, व्हेन द लेयर आर फार अवे दे आर कॉल्ड एज रेयरफैक्शंस. तो यहाँ पर क्या है? यहाँ पर डेंसिटी हाई है, यहाँ पर क्या है? डेंसिटी कम है. तो इसको पॉइंट में कैसे लिखूंगा मैं? एट द कॉम्प्रेशंस वी से दैट द डेंसिटी and the pressure dono bhi, and the pressure of the medium is maximum. Barabar na? Because they are very close to each other. While at rarefaction kya hoga? Uska opposite hoga. At rarefaction mein kya ho raha hai? Density bhi kam hai aur pressure bhi kam hoga. At rarefaction the density and the pressure of the medium is, I am erasing this, yaad rahega na, is minimum. So this is all about your longitudinal waves. How do they look and how do they travel? So the propagation of sound in the medium, first we studied about the longitudinal waves. I showed you diagrammatically how the energy is being transferred from one position, from one particle to the other particle, but the particle itself is not traveling. It is just transferring the energy to the next particle, and this way the sound propagates. So when they are colliding with each other, they either come closer to each other or they are far away from each other. When they come closer to each other, they become denser and their pressure increases. When they are far away, their density becomes less and also the pressure becomes less. Such close particles are called as compressions, and the far away particles are called as rarefactions. So that's why longitudinal waves ke andar first we studied how the wave is formed. One complete to and fro, ja ke wapas aana, particles jata bhi hai aur wapas aata bhi hai. Barabar hai? Aage jata hai to strike and piche aata hai wapas to cover the density. So one complete to and fro motion of a strip or any vibrating object from one compression and one rarefaction together makes one wave. Barabar, how do we define the longitudinal wave? The waves in which the particles of the medium are vibrating there and there, that is about their mean position, but in the direction of the sound, in the direction of the propagation of the sound, are called as longitudinal waves. अब ये एक्चुअली किस में देखा जाता है? इन एयर देखा जाता है. इसके लिए लिखा गया है दैट साउंड ट्रेवल्स इन एयर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स. बट ऐसे देखा जाए तो इट ट्रेवल्स इन ऑल द थ्री मीडियम. ये LW का मतलब है लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स. लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन ऑल द थ्री स्टेट्स, दैट इज सॉलिड्स, लिक्विड्स एंड गैशियस एज अ मीडियम. ओके, अभी जैसे डायग्रामेटिकली आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट ये जो होता है कॉम्प्रेशंस यानी क्लोज्ड लेयर मतलब डेंसिटी एज वेल एज प्रेशर बोथ विल बी मैक्सिमम. And rarefactions, I told you, they are far away. Far away मतलब क्या हुआ? Density भी कम हो गया और pressure भी कम हो गया. So such layer इसमें where the rarefactions are there the density and pressure is minimum. Got it? आगे बढ़ते हैं. Now we study about the second type of wave. After studying the longitudinal wave, the second type of wave is a transverse wave. Now let me take a simple example. Now suppose if there is a pond, in a pond if I throw a stone inside it, what would happen is it will create a disturbance throughout the pond, throughout the water. Ye pura medium ke andar, water, liquid medium ke andar, there will be disturbance. But this disturbance will be in the form of aise upar niche karke waves aayenge. So what you find is there will be circular ripples around it. These are called ripples. A small waves are called ripples in this. So here they are traveling in the form of waves, but how are the waves moving? They are moving up and down, up and down. Can you see the movement is up, or here in this case down, but the wave is traveling in forward direction. So can I say they are perpendicular to each other? Samajh mein aa raha hai na? The wave is traveling in a forward direction, in this forward direction. But the particle, the movement of the particles is up and down. That is why we get the upper portion, lower portion, upper and the lower wave. The upper portion is called as your crest part, and the lower portion is called as your trough part. Getting it? So we have alternate crest and trough. So when we get alternate crest and trough, we say that they are transverse waves. Okay? So let me explain you further. इसी के अंदर सपोज इफ आई टेक लेट मी वेट अ मिनट. नाउ इन दिस इटसेल्फ सपोज इफ आई टेक एक रीजन की तरह पूछ सकते हैं. सपोज इफ अ कॉर्क एक लकड़ी का एकदम पतला एकदम लो डेंसिटी वाला इफ अ पीस ऑफ कॉर्क ऑन वाटर सरफेस के ऊपर अगर डालेंगे ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ द वाटर इट डज नॉट move ahead. But wave is moving ahead. Getting it? उसका reason क्या हो सकता है? The reason is, मैंने बताया आपको, the particles are not carrying. अगर particles were supposed to carry, अगर ये particle cork को लेके carry करता, तो particle के साथ साथ cork यहाँ पर आता. But यहाँ पर ऐसे नहीं हो रहा है. Waves के अंदर क्या होता है? The particles transfer the energy to the next particle, to the next particle, to the next particle, to the next particle. So this way, the transfer of energy goes on. So only the particles are being transmitted, particles, the energy is being transmitted, but the particle is not traveling. So what happens is, this piece of cork will remain and just move up and down. Just move up and down. क्यों? क्योंकि waves create हो रहा है. तो waves create हो रहा है, इसके लिए the cork will move only up and down, but the particles will transfer the energy to the next particle and a wave will be formed. That's the reason why the cork does not move ahead, but the waves proceed ahead. समझा? How do we put up? इसको reason लिखेंगे. The particles of water start vibrating up and down. बताया मैंने up and down at the point where the stone strikes. अब ये stone strike किया तभी तो ripples आया, और ripples आने के बाद में I have placed a cork, piece of cork in the, on the water surface. तो वहां पर क्या हो रहा है? ओनली द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द वॉटर आर मूविंग अप एंड डाउन. वाइब्रेशन खाली पार्टिकल्स का हो रहा है, पार्टिकल्स सब अप एंड डाउन हो रहे हैं. अप एंड डाउन, ये जा रहा है ऊपर की तरफ, देखा आपने, वापस ऊपर की तरफ, वापस ऊपर की तरफ, वापस ऊपर की तरफ, अभी नीचे आ रहा है, अभी नीचे आ रहा है, अभी नीचे आ रहा है, अभी वापस ऊपर गया, ऊपर गया. सो दिस वे अप एंड डाउन मूवमेंट गोज ऑन, बराबर है, ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स. नाउ ये जो पार्टिकल्स है, दिस पार्टिकल्स then transfer, they transfer their own energy to the neighbor one, to the other neighboring particles and वो खुद क्या करेगा, वापस से रिटर्न हो जाएगा. एंड दे themselves कम बैक टू their मेन पोजिशन. जैसे longitudinal में भी पढ़ा था हम लोग ने, हाई डेंसिटी लो डेंसिटी, वैसे वो वापस से अपनी जगह पर आ जाएगा. ये कब तक चलेगा? जब तक वेव्स का इंटेंसिटी कम नहीं होता. दिस प्रोसेस continues and thus जो disturbance create हुआ था, जो vibration, जो wave जो form हुआ था, the disturbance moves ahead on the water surface in the form of waves. बट कॉर्क कहां पर है? इट इज लोकलाइज्ड, वो वहीं के वहीं रहेगा. ओनली द पार्टिकल्स विल ट्रांसफर द एनर्जी, बट द कॉर्क पार्टिकल विल जस्ट वाइब्रेट अप एंड डाउन. समझ में आ रहा है व्हाई द पीस ऑफ कॉर्क विच इज प्लेस्ड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ वाटर डज नॉट मूव अहेड, बट ओनली द वेव्स आर मूविंग अहेड, बिकॉज द पार्टिकल्स स्टार्ट वाइब्रेटिंग. वेन द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ वाटर स्टार्ट वाइब्रेटिंग, दे वाइब्रेट अप एंड डाउन एट देयर एट द पॉइंट वेयर द स्टोन हैज स्ट्रकन. Then these particles then transfer their own energy to the neighboring particle and they themselves come back to their mean position. जैसे वापस आ जाएगा, the wave आगे propagate होते जाएगा. This process continues and thus the disturbance move ahead in the form of wave. But the cork will remain in the same position, just moving up and down. Got it? I give reason.
So now we actually see about what are the transverse waves, the properties and the features and the definition and everything about transverse waves. How do we define it? मैंने बताया ना अभी, it is traveling perpendicular, इस तरह से जा रहा है, मतलब they are traveling up, ये mean position है आपका, यहाँ पर एक mean position है, तो क्या हो रहा है, either up या down, मतलब they are moving perpendicular, तो याद रखना ये word perpendicular, so therefore we define it as the wave in which the particles of the medium vibrate about their mean position, but कहां पर, which direction, in a direction which is perpendicular, in a direction perpendicular to the direction of traveling or propagation of the wave. Such type of wave is called as the transverse wave. Let me go through it again. क्या लिखा है? The waves in which the particles of the medium, ये जो particles है, ये सब particles है. Getting it? ये सब particles है. The waves in which the particles of the medium vibrate about their mean position. ये आपका mean position है. ये आपका mean position. तो mean position के ऊपर नीचे एक दूसरे को टकरा के particles को आगे की तरफ भेज रहा है. आगे की तरफ energy transfer होते जा रहा है. About their mean position in the direction perpendicular. देख रहे हो ना, perpendicular. यहाँ पर भी perpendicular है. Straight line, downwards. But they are moving perpendicular. But the wave is moving in this direction. So direction is perpendicular. किस कौन से direction को? Direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. Wave is traveling in this direction and the wave is moving in perpendicular direction. Such type of wave is called as a transverse wave. समझ में आया? Okay. अभी इसके अंदर क्या क्या था, जैसे हम लोग ने पढ़ा था, देयर इन लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वेव्स इट वॉज मेड अप ऑफ टू थिंग्स, दैट इज कॉम्प्रेशन एंड रेरिफैक्शन. तो यहां पर क्या है अपने पास, दो चीजें, अपर पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज द क्रेस्ट एंड द लोअर पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड एज द ट्रफ. तो हम लोग पॉइंट आउट पुट अप कर देंगे, ट्रांसवर्स वेव इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ a crest and a trough. Crest is your upper portion and trough is your lower portion. Upper displacement is called crest and the lower displacement is called as a trough. Okay? इसमें ऊपर नीचे जो होता है, ऊपर वाला, अच्छा let me describe the crest part. The position of मैक्सिमम अपवर्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट, जब अपवर्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट है तो इट इज कॉल्ड क्रेस्ट. अपवर्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज कॉल्ड अ क्रेस्ट, और जो डाउनवर्ड रहेगा उसको हम लोग ट्रफ बोलेंगे. एंड द पोजिशन ऑफ अगेन मैक्सिमम डाउनवर्ड displacement is called as a trough, is called a trough. Okay, ये हो गया. अब ये क्या होता है, alternate होते ही रहता है, एक के बाद आते ही रहता है. और कहां पर, in which medium this transverse waves can only be produced in solids and on the surface. अभी देखा ना हम लोग ने, surface of water or liquids.
डीप अंदर काम नहीं आएगा. समझ में आ रहा है? आई एम इरेजिंग दिस एंड वॉट. बाकी मीडियम के लिए नॉट एट ऑल, इनसाइड नॉट एट ऑल. सो वी पुट अप दैट दे कैन नॉट, ये एमसीक्यूज के लिए है, इसके लिए आई एम पुटिंग अप ऑन द नोट. दे कैन नॉट बी प्रोड्यूस्ड, दे कैन नॉट बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इनसाइड द लिक्विड एंड ऑल्सो इन गैसेज, दे कैन नॉट बी प्रोपोगेटेड. समझ में आ रहा है? दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर ट्रांसवर्स वेव. वापस से एक बार ड्रॉ करके बता देता हूँ. ये एक मीन पोजिशन है. द पार्टिकल्स वेन दे स्टार्ट मूविंग दे मूव मैक्सिमम अपवर्ड एंड मैक्सिमम डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट. सो ये मैक्सिमम अपवर्ड मूवमेंट इज योर क्रेस्ट एंड मैक्सिमम डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट इज योर ट्रफ. And this one complete, starting from mean position and ending at mean position after completing one crest and one trough makes one single wave. Got it? So this is all about your transverse wave. Just note down. It can come for differentiation also. So I have already listed out the points for longitudinal waves and these are the points for the transverse waves. Combine them together and make a good difference between the longitudinal and transverse waves. So after understanding about the longitudinal and the transverse wave, how the particles move, how the energy is transferred from this two type of waves, what we studied, we can categorize or we can put up the characteristics of wave motion, how the wave moves, how the energy is transferred. Let us see. जो भी वेव होता है, अ वेव इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द पीरियोडिक टाइम टू टाइम बाय द पीरियोडिक डिस्टर्बेंसेस एट एनी पॉइंट और एट अ पॉइंट इन द मीडियम. अगर कोई भी मीडियम के अंदर इफ यू प्रोड्यूस अ डिस्टर्बेंस, there will be a vibration and there will be a wave which is produced, and this is how the wave starts moving. So for the wave to move, there should be a periodic disturbance. Kahan par? At a point, kahin par bhi, in the medium, chahe solid, liquid ya gases ho. So that is your first point. Second point mein kya bola tha maine already, do type ke waves mein, due to propagation, kya ho raha hai? Jab propagation hota hai, to hota kya hai actually? Propagation due to propagation of wave in a medium, what happens is the particles क्या हो रहा है? Energy को सिर्फ transfer कर रहा है. Particles move नहीं हो रहा है, आगे नहीं जा रहा है, खाली वो वहीं का वहीं mean position पे vibrate कर रहा है. The in the medium, the particles of the medium just vibrate about their mean position. बोला था वही, खाली mean position पे vibrate करेगा, लेकिन उसका energy तो transfer होगा. And the energy is transferred with a constant speed. With a constant speed from one point of a medium to the other place or other point. समझ में आ रहा है? इसमें क्या था important? Due to the propagation of the wave, in the medium, the particles जो भी है, they just vibrate about their mean position. And secondly, the energy is transferred with a constant speed from one place to other place. Getting it? So this we have inferred or understood from the two types of waves. Ki waves jo bhi produce hota hai, wo because of the disturbance produce hota hai. Waves jo bhi propagate karega, to jo bhi particles hai, wo vibrate karega, but only in their सेम पोजिशन, यानी कि एट द सेम लोकेशन, यानी कि मेन पोजिशन पर ही वो पार्टिकल्स वाइब्रेट होगा.
और जब वो पार्टिकल्स वाइब्रेट हो रहा है तो उसकी वजह से जो एनर्जी जनरेट हो रहा है दैट एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर पॉइंट. सो दिस आर द टू मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ अ वेव व्हेन द वेव इज इन मोशन.